Hi guys and welcome back. And today we get on with building the first of, I think, what will be six figures for the Slava Ukraini tribute diorama, and that is the figure of Arina Klimova. So this is a 1/35th scale Masterbox figure from their Desert Battle Series kit number 3, Skull Clan Long Distance Raid. And it's kit number MB35215. Not a kit that I would typically normally buy, but when I was browsing through the online hobby shop, I thought she would make a good citizen's militia figure with a little bit of additional stuff whacked on. So that's what we're going to do today. So we'll have a look at the plastic, and it's one sprue, which sort of took me by surprise in such a big box. Very nicely molded doggy in two halves. I think it's a German Shepherd. Well, looks like one to me. Well, that might have a bit of a back problem. The figure itself, a number of different parts. I'll be using most of them. The face is pretty good. It's actually quite representative of the box art. Very determined look on her face, which is a look we've come to associate with the Ukrainians. Very determined people. So on with the build, and started with building the female figure first of all. As you can see, cutting things off. No flash. I was very happy with the modding. Sometimes master box can be a bit hit and miss. And by magic, save you all the boring bits. Cleaned up easily, glued together well. A few little gaps around the arms, that's normal, and around the waist. We can fix that up with some putty, but otherwise, very easy to put together. So just doing a bit of cleanup on the back of the figure, so it's sort of like a jacket, I think might be maybe a hoodie in the original moulding, and didn't want that there because I want to get some equipment. So scraped it off with the Dremel, filing, a bit of Tamiya thin to get rid of any of the furry bits, and using her backpack, it's got the little teddy bear on the back, and that will be from her memento of her son, who was safely evacuated to Poland with his aunt. So it's a mixed bunch of equipment, and I figured Citizens Militia, there's stuff flying in from everywhere around the globe to support the Ukrainians, which is fantastic. So Citizens Militia probably wouldn't have a standard kit. They'd get whatever they could get their hands on. So just now putting a little bit of webbing on, which is just very, very thin tin, which I quite like, securing it with super glue, and then it'll pretty much conform to whatever sort of configuration that you want. So as I said before, there were a few little gaps in the joining of the various parts, so had to get the old two-part epoxy putty out and fill those in. You've seen me use this a million times if you're a regular viewer. I like it because it almost needs no sanding. You get a little bit of water on that silicon tipped sculpting tool, smooth it all out, and there's very little work left after it's dried. Now the figure's sculpted, I think they're 3/4 pants. I'm not high up on women's fashion, but I didn't think that looked right wandering in towards the enemy. So just filled that up with the putty as well to make long combat pants. So on with the painting, and everyone got a coat of the Vallejo Black Surface Primer, which is a quite nice paint. I like it. It always gives you a good starting point. And then all I'm doing then is blocking in the main colors, so the boots and the pants, and just going for sort of a greeny look, which I'll ultimately attempt to turn into some digital camo, and going for some pretty bright colors initially, as you can see, but with the various washes that will go on later on, that will darken all that up and dull it down quite a fair bit. And just working my way through, no particular batting order. Sometimes I start from the feet and work my way up. Sometimes I start from the head and work my way down. Just getting the hair in here, blondie. And that's the base colors fundamentally done. So I was pretty happy with how the dog turned out, and after just giving him an initial base coat of brown, a dark brown, then I used the rust and dust paint set and just used various rust colours, get a good strong dark rust base colour down, and then used a variety of progressively lighter rust colours, semi sort of dry brushed to pick up the highlights, and you know, one coat sort of went over the other and some stayed and some got replaced by the even lighter coat. So there was no great science to it, and it was really, you know, like everything I do, you keep going until you're sort of happy. And then got onto the details of the doggy, his tongue and his nose and his eyes and just around his feet and that sort of stuff, and a little bit of whiskerage. And I think he came up pretty decent in the finish. So just trying to get the webbing for the rifle sling through her hand, which I drilled out. I've done most of the detail painting now, and look, I didn't film that because my nose is literally touching the figure when I do the detail painting, but I was happy with the various different types of camo. I said digital camo earlier, and it was sort of the attempt, but it's just a generic camo. But yeah, got the drilled out the hole through the hand for the rifle sling, made a couple of little hooks out of very fine wire, and the tin foil for the strap, which I largely painted before I put it on, so that I just had little bits of touch-up to do. And now it's time for some oil washes. So the first one I did was just some black oil paint and some white mineral spirits, and just mix that up. It was pretty thin solution, not heavily pigmented, and didn't splash that on like a lunatic. I was really just looking to get some dark shadows in the equipment and some of the more shaded areas of the figure, I guess, if that makes sense. And then followed that up with a brown ochre and applied that more liberally across both the figures. Again, trying mainly to get it into the crevices. And then finished all that off with Vallejo's matte acrylic varnish. And the combination of that and the darker washes had really brought the colours down nicely. So hang on for a tick, and we'll come back with the final reveal. So here we go, all done now. A little bit of weathering, mud on the boots. Forgot to mention during the making of the video that the blue electrical tape around her right arm is in fact blue electrical tape, so I just cut a very thin strip and then stretched it so it was thin in thickness as well, and a couple of layers of that. And all in all, really pleased with how she came up. I'm particularly happy with her eyes. I reckon they might be the best eyes that I've ever done, because you've got the very pale blue of the iris with the black pupil in there as well. And of course, really pleased with the doggo. So as always, guys, look, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I need you to give me some help. I've got two foreign volunteers figures to do next, so I'm looking for names and countries of origins for those two guys. Leave some comments down below. Thanks for watching. Like if you liked. Share if you have socials to share on. Please subscribe and make sure you click on the bell. And I will catch you in the next one. Take care all, and Slava Ukraini.